We're coming to you live from Don't Ever Bank Here Field in Croxham Skull, Florida. It's over 110 degrees outside. Man, is it hot. The only difference between this place and an oven is that ovens don't produce serial killers. And today's matchup is going to be a good one. The teams are taking the field. The Leveland Burns take on the Croxham Skull Jugulars. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. If you like your cocktail cold, your soup hot, and your steak still mooing, then you're gonna love seeing mutants knocked cold, their brains turned into hot lava soup, and their bodies strewn about the field, lying still and barely moving. MFL Game Day is on the air.
Ah, you just made me hungry, Grim. I'm gonna go get some of them extra crispy mutant finger strips.
Hey, get me a full slab of broken mutant ribs while you're there.
And it's first and 10. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. Kaboom! And the quarterback unleashes a sonic blast against the defense.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
And it's first and 10. Second down in a mile. He could go all the way. And the quarterback drills one in for the first down. And it's first and 10. Bathroom. First down. First down and 7. Second down and 9. Well, this should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. Straight through the uprights. They need a good return here to set up the offense. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
And it's first and 10. And that is called for a first down. It's first and 10. And he snatches that one out of the air for a first down. See if the coach isn't liking that call. Oh, his head just exploded. They're back up here on first, and they've had enough. The offense jumps off sides and attacks the ref. First down and a mile. Second down and more than the QB would like. Well, as a quarterback, you have to take risks and just chuck.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
And it's first and 10. Look out, that's an all-out attack on the kick.
It's not how many times you fall, it's how you get back up.
Yeah, in this particular case, I'm thinking defibrillators and 100 cc's of adrenaline.
Yeah, they both wouldn't hurt either.
Did somebody say cocaine?
And it's first and 10. His bell rung for a yard. Second down and 9. And this guy's like a human cannonball. First down.
Yeah, my next door neighbor was a human cannonball, Grim. He drowned in his pool.
And it's first and 10. That run is good for 10 yards. Second down in inches. Defenders like a greased turkey. And they line up for the extra point. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and 10. Heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole, up here. Talking to you.
Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
Third down and 3. first down with a nice piece of running there. And it's first and 10. Second down and a lot. You've got to catch that. Quarter one comes to an end. If they don't get it together, this game is going to turn into a rout. Third down and the punter is warming up. It's a punishing hit. Now here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. No return on this punt. The defense will just down it.
I can't tell if he's smart or scared. Either way, the ball's down.
And it's first and 10. That's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutiny.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. That's a 6-yard gain. And that'll bring up third down and inches. Like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
It sounds like my offseason.
And it's first and 10. Second down in a very lot. Just follow the bloody footprints to the new line. That's a first down. And it's first and 10. First and 10. And the defense gives up 5 yards there. Second down and 5. Heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole.
Third down and 5. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown! And the ref is picking up a wad of singles as he runs off the field.
I didn't think he got those, Grim.
Didn't you see him stripping on the sidelines? He's bribed you, idiot.
Third down, and offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Hopefully the next guy learns, or we're going to have a pile of dead refs. Third down, and the QB is saying his prayers. Woo! I'd be impressed if he splits the uprights from this far away, Bricks.
If he doesn't, they're gonna split his skull wide open.
The defense called a sticky ball dirty trick, and the quarterback is in a shitload of trouble. And that's what's so frustrating about kickers. They're all head cases.
All that work, and they come up empty. That sucks.
And it's first and ten. The defense answers into a mutant fireball with that flame on dirty trick, and anything he touches gets clumpied. And that'll be a first down. You know, Bricks, a lot of people have gotten pass happy in this league. Nice to see some old school mano a mano on the turf, huh? And it's first and ten. And they call a ginormous dirty trick.
He's so big that the last time he saw 90210 was on the bathroom scale.
Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day.
Bricks, it's the two-minute warning. You know what that means?
Whiskey?
And it's first and ten. The quarterback has had enough and calls a murder ball dirty trick to lay waste to the defense. And pass was way off target, but I'm pretty sure the QB will blame the receiver as he always does. Second down and ten. Not much there, maybe a yard. And they stop the clock with their first timeout to try and stay in this game.
Oh, nice coaching move there. Hall of Fame caliber.
Well, I mean, it's a pretty standard coaching move at this point of the game.
I won't listen to this blasphemy.
Nice run for 5 yards. The defense calls timeout. They must be trying to get on their QB's good side. Thank God he's still got his leg. He's going to need all of it for this kick.
Hey, a Sawbuck says he misses.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and, or bloodthirsty, whichever. Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right.
And that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made into dice, Grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
Call man about a 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Bricks.
They've got one more timeout left, but they've stopped the clock.
Why don't they just take the batteries out of the clock, Grim? That would make more sense.
And the offense goes into their two-minute drill.
Which coincidentally happens to be Bricks' match stupsing time. That's why the girls call me Speedy Gonzalez.
Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. And that'll be their final timeout. Time to speed things up. The offense goes into a two-minute drill. Oh, big catch, big run, big touchdown.
And big deal. Mr. Meat for Brain ran with a ball and didn't fall down.
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just guineas.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make him pay. And the quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out. And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered Frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. We're back for the second half as the teams line up for the kickoff. The coach told his players they'll be strung up on the goalposts if they don't make this a game in the second half.
That's how you motivate these pricks.
Just want dirt and some butter time.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's first and ten. And he sticks his fingers in the defender's eyes, netting him a pickup of about 8 on the play. Second down and 2. And with a burst of speed, he finds an opening and the first down. It's first and 10.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
That's a catch for a 10-yard gain. Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown! I like this. They're going for 2. That's a beautiful pass for the conversion. Oh, man, I'd rather watch my big toenail being removed by a weasel than watch this.
That's how I got rid of my toenail foot fungus, Grim. Found this weasel on the internet that did it for a can of sardines. Cheap. It pays to be smart when it comes to medical procedures.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
And it's first and 10.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into.
And the defense jumps on sides and attacks. And the whistle blows the play dead, along with the quarterback.
Yeah, you're damn good, Tyler. I only we can have a shot.
It's first and 10. Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? First down and 1. Hey, Bricks, they're going for 2 here. And the defense stops him cold. That play just got blown to hell.
It got blown to shit.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. It's first and 10. The receiver makes a grab for 5 yards. Second down and 5. Runs it for 3. Second down and 7. That ball just sliced through the defense like butter. And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. It's first and 10. And into the end zone for a touchdown. Once he got his hands on that pass, he was off to the races. Man, are these guys greedy or desperate? Either way, they're going for 2. He caught it. That's 2 points and even more momentum on their side.
I can feel the momentum shifting.
For the last time, you're not a Jedi, Bricks. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, Bricks. It means he can return it for... You know what? Never mind. And that's the way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 on that play. And it's first and 10. First down. And it's first and 10. And he zings it in there for a 9-yard completion. They are moving the ball now with authority. That'll bring up 2nd and 1. put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done. And here comes the extra point attempt. It's good. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and ten.
Didn't cripple him? It certainly left skid marks.
And it's first and ten. I personally think that the ginormous guy is compensating for something, but I won't be dropped it. If he does that again, they'll drop him. Second down and ten. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
Third down and long. Talk about butterfingers, he should have had that one. Don't do anything stupid here. Just punt the damn ball and play defense. And he got it off. That's a decent punt. And he snags the punt and looks for open field.
I had a dog named Snags.
Oh, with the brutal hit. The third quarter has ended, and we'll need a huge rally or a high death toll to make this one interesting. And it's first and ten. Nicely done for a first down. The offense lost another quarterback on the previous play and have only two left before they have to forfeit.
Yeah, but on the bright side, Glenn, they save a ton of money by not having to pay those guys anymore. That's a funeral expense, that is.
And it's first and ten. Maybe the QB should throw it and catch it too. Second down and ten. And that's how you run it, folks. Picks up eight there. Third and two. Looks like a pass, and it's bouncing right back to the QB. Oh, it's the sticky ball dirty trick.
Ah, pass the popcorn, Grim. Zoom in on his face, then his crotch. I want to see if he cries or pisses himself first.
And out comes the most underrated position in football, the mighty punter. The punter for today is being played by my kid's sister. Or at least it seems like. Nice catch, and he turns on the afterburners. Punt returners in this league have a life expectancy of 3 returns. Let's see if he beats the odds. Oh, with the brain scrambler. And it's first and ten. Good thing they don't have drug testing at the end. crusher right there, folks. And it's first and 10. Oh, and the quarterback threads the needle for a first down. First down and 9. And stop this or they're gonna lose.
Not like they need any help with that, though, Grim. These guys are doing fine by themselves.
And this is a first and the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. First down and forever, and they've had enough. The offense jumps off sides and attacks the ref. First down and a mile. He's not just burning down the house, he's taking it to the house. And there aren't many things better than a running back blasting through the defense for a big gain.
Except pizza.
Yeah, I'm sure you got pizza.
And burritos.
Okay, you make a good point.
Oh, and pickles. Gotta have pickles.
Second down and long. This guy's gonna get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. Third down and the punter is warming up. Nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sinners then.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chick wearing a wig.
And it's first and 10. Oh, man, what a throw. That sonic blast just cleared the field for the receiver. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after 3, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
And like every one of my barbecues, this guy's on fire. Does he like original or extra crispy? Now it looks like extra crispy. Boom! And it's first and 10. And the 2-minute warning sounds, they'll have to regroup during this timeout. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. Man, what a hit that was! smart move there as they call a timeout, trying to get the ball back for another shot. Third down and 10. Down and offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Third down and never gonna happen. And that's perfect coverage. Nice deflection. Sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. And he booted a high arcing rainbow. And it's first and 10. QB saves some clock by calling a timeout. They have one left. And it's first and 10. Deep into a 4-yard pickup there.
And timeouts are kind of like condoms, you know, Grim? You got to use them smart if you want to score. Let's see if they did.
Second down and 6. Offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yawn.
And it's first and 10. Oh, and that's how you play defense. Well, of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown, and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick.
I do. The guy should have fucking caught it.
Way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. And that one's incomplete. The receiver couldn't get there.
Oh, my God. A man from prison just came out of the field.
That's the ref, you idiot. Let's see what the penalty is. First down and 3. Now it looks like the coach is ripping that play from the playbook. What a dud.
Wow, the Cranksums go jugular. Just like a big fat stinker on the living room floor today.
They're playing like babies and crap their pants. They ought to wear diapers next game like me.
They battled, but didn't have enough to get it done.
They choked like a bunch of banana choking chimp chumps choking on a bag of chimp dicks.
Say choking on a bag of chip dicks?
Yeah.
God, that was beautiful. Grim Blitzro with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Eagle SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's game was brought to you by Comcrack Entertainment. They're not happy until you're not happy.